Hello students, and today we are here back again to discuss a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is pronouns. So without wasting much of our time, let us go directly to the topic. We'll be trying to understand pronouns and its types. Okay, this chapter, the explanation of this chapter, I am doing in two videos. Both the videos you will have on the same day. Okay, if you are receiving the first video today, the second video also you will receive today itself, and along with that the video where I will explain you how to solve the exercises of pronouns. Okay, so you have to see both the videos and try to understand, and after it is done you will try to solve the exercises. Okay, so pronouns and their types. First of all, let us try to understand what is pronouns. Okay, pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. Okay, now for example, if we are writing a paragraph about India, okay, suppose we are writing a paragraph about India or a person. Okay, let us say we are writing a paragraph about our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. So in the first sentence or in the second sentence, we may use Mr. Narendra Modi, but In every sentence later on also we are not continuously going to use the name, the noun, that is Mr. Narendra Modi. We will use him, his, he, things like that, or words like that. So these words are used in place of the noun. Okay, these words are used in place of the noun. These words are called pronouns. Okay, the words that is used in place of nouns are called pronouns. So with the help of pronouns, what happens is we are able to, we don't have to use noun again and again. That is the advantage, or that is the use of pronouns. Okay, now when we are talking about the type of pronouns, the type of pronouns are divided into two parts. Okay, one type is according to case. There are types of cases of pronouns, and then there is types of pronoun. Okay, we will be discussing both. First, we will look into the different cases, how pronoun is present in a sentence. In a sentence, pronoun can come in different way, or in different, it can be presented in different ways. Let us look at which are the different ways in which the pronoun is presented, that is cases. Okay, now the first case of pronoun is nominative case. Okay, the nominative case, or we can also call it the subjective case, or nominative case. What happens is, in a nominative case or in a subjective case, the pronoun which is in the sentence, it is the subject of the sentence. It is presented as the subject of the sentence. Matlab, the sentence is told about that pronoun only. Okay, he is my friend. So that sentence is about he, and he is a pronoun. So he is in subjective case. Okay, that sentence, in the sentence, he is the subject. The sentence is told about he, and he is a pronoun. So that is why in that sentence we can say that he is in subjective form. That is the case of he there. Okay, here we have one example, that is he is the winner of the match. Here we are talking about he is a pronoun. He is used for some noun. He is a pronoun here, and he is the subject. The sentence is told about he. So that is why he is in the nominative case here. The pronoun is in nominative case here, or we can say the pronoun is the subject in the sentence, and that is why it is in nominative case or in subjective case. Okay, then next one is objective case. That is, if the pronoun is in the sentence, the pronoun is present as an object in the sentence. Object means the receiver of the action. Subject does the action, doer of the action. So, and object is the receiver of the action, who is getting the action, on which the action is being done. So if the pronoun is in subject, it is the nominative case. But sometimes pronoun are as an object, matlab these pronouns are the receiver of the action. They are getting the action, or the action is done on them. In such cases, we will tell that the pronoun is in objective case. It is working as an object in the sentence, so it is in objective case. Let us look at the example. Mitra had called us to the birthday party. Here in this sentence, the subject is Mitra, because what is the action? Calling. So who is doing the action of calling? Mitra. So Mitra is the subject of the sentence, but मित्रा इज डूइंग द एक्शन ऑफ कॉलिंग ऑन हुम, किसको बुला रही है, हुम इज शी कॉलिंग, अस, सो वी आर द रिसीवर ऑफ द एक्शन, मित्रा कॉल्ड हुम, अस, सो द एक्शन इज डन ऑन अस, सो वी आर, अस इज द रिसीवर ऑफ द एक्शन, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस अस द प्रोनाउन is the object, and that is why we can say that in this sentence the pronoun us is in objective case. Okay, if the pronoun is doing the work of a subject, then it is in subjective case. If the pronoun is doing the work of object, then it is objective case. Okay, now let us look at the last case, that is possessive case. Possessive case means in a sentence if pronoun is showing possession, that is something belongs to the pronoun, mine, ours, yours, ठीक है, if it is showing possession, ownership, then that pronoun is in possessive case, okay, if it is the subject, subjective case, if it is the object, objective case, and if the pronoun is showing a possession, then it is in possessive case. I hope you are clear with the three cases. So this is one type of types of pronouns. Let us go to the next one. Now we have other types of pronoun, okay. The other, first was the case, the other types of pronoun, in that the first one is personal pronouns. Okay, we need to understand why do we call it personal pronouns. Okay, we call these pronouns personal pronouns because these pronouns are dependent on persons. First person, second person, third person. So these pronouns are dependent on persons. What is the person according to the according to that will be the pronoun. So these pronouns, because they are dependent on these persons, that is why they are called personal pronouns. Okay, that is why they are called personal pronouns. We first need to understand these persons. Okay, let me try to explain you the persons. Here if you go to see, if you look at the list, there is a table given, and on the in the table the first column is person, the second column is subject, that is the doer of the action, and the third column is object, that is the receiver of the action. That is, in this person, subjective case mein what will be the pronoun, objective case mein what will be the pronoun, another person, so uska subjective case mein what will be the pronoun, uska objective case mein what will be the pronoun, next person, usme subjective case mein what will be the pronoun, uska objective case mein what will be the pronoun. This is how this table is explained, and I am sending a photo of this table to all students along with the video. And you have to do one thing, is that you have to learn this table. We don't have any other option. We have to learn this table by heart. Okay. Now the learning कैसे होना चाहिए? जैसे कि first person singular. Okay. If I am asking you first person singular, what is the subjective case pronoun? You should be able to tell me. Okay. And if I am asking you third person plural, what is the subjective case pronoun? So you should be able to tell they. Okay, in that way you have to learn this table. Okay, the photo will be sent to you along with the video. Okay, now let me explain you the table. The first person, in the list of persons, the first one is first person singular. First person singular. We must first understand what is first person, what is second person, and what is third person. First person is always the speaker. The speaker is the first person. If I am saying a sentence, if I am speaking a sentence, I am dictating or telling a sentence, I am the first person. Okay, I am the first person. All the speaker is the first person. Okay, now let me explain it a little bit more. If the speaker, that means if I am speaking something, I am the first person. If I am alone, so it is first person singular. Okay. I am the speaker, I am alone, I am only one, then it is first person singular. If I am speaking and there are many people with me who also are speaking, so it is not I the pronoun that we use, it is we the pronoun that we use, isn't it? Because it is more than one. Ek se zyada ho gaye, ek akela hai to I, first person singular. Agar bolne wale bahut sare log hain, so it is plural. First person plural. Okay, so speaker is one, so first person singular. If the speakers are many altogether, then it is first person plural. Okay, now second person, who is the second person? Second person is the listener, to whom the listener or to whom the sentence is being told. If I am speaking and I am speaking to you, so I am speaking, so I am the first person, and to you I am speaking, so you are the second person. Understood? So if you are speaking, you are the first person, and if you are speaking to me, so I become the second person. Okay? So speaker is the first person, and to whom is the sentence spoken, that person becomes the second person. Now in second person also there is singular and plural, but the pronouns used for the second person, singular and plural, both are same. You all is also correct, and you alone is also correct. Okay, so in second person the singular plural pronouns are same. Now let me come to the third person. Third person, I am the speaker, the first person, to you I am speaking, so you are the second person. But if we are talking about somebody else, मैं भी नहीं तुम भी नहीं मैं किसी और के बारे में बोल रहा हूं, ठीक है, दैट पर्सन बिकम्स द थर्ड पर्सन. ओके, दैट पर्सन कैन बी सिंगुलर ऑल्सो, एंड वी कैन टॉक अबाउट मेनी पीपल, सो दैट बिकम्स थर्ड पर्सन प्लूरल. ओके, सो इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग आई एम द फर्स्ट पर्सन, आई एम अलोन, द फर्स्ट पर्सन सिंगुलर. इफ विथ मी मेनी पीपल आर स्पीकिंग, सो फर्स्ट पर्सन प्लूरल. आई एम स्पीकिंग टू यू, सो यू बिकम द सेकेंड पर्सन. ओके, you are alone, so you are second person singular. You are many, so you become second person plural. But in second person singular and plural, the pronouns are the same. We both are talking, we are talking about somebody else, and that is one person, so that is third person singular. We are talking and we are talking about many people, so they are third person, but many people, so that is why third person plural. Okay, so this is the description of persons. First person, second person, third person. Singular, plural, singular, plural, singular and plural. Okay, so now let me explain you. First person singular, the subjective case pronoun is I. Okay, and the objective case pronoun is me. First person plural, the subjective case pronoun is we, and the objective case pronoun is us. In second person, the subjective case pronoun is you, and the objective case pronoun is also you. Now I have written, now here you can understand, that is you, subject is also you and object is also you. How will we understand which is subject and which is object? If you is written before the verb, before the action, it is the subject, and if you is written after the verb, after the action, it is the object. Okay, now let me go to the third person. Third person singular, third person singular is, if it is a boy, so subject is he, object is him. If the third person singular is a girl, feminine gender, subject is she, subjective case is she, and objective case is her. And if the third person singular is a common gender or neuter gender, generally neuter gender, the subjective case is it, and the objective case is also it. Now there also both subject, object, both are it. So if it comes before the subject, before the verb, it is a subject, and if it comes after the verb, it is the object. And the last person, third person plural, third person, many people are there. The subjective case is they and objective case is them. Okay, students, in this way you have to learn this chart by heart. Okay, we don't have any other option. You have to learn this chart by heart. According to that we will understand the word. Once you learn this, it will be very easy for you to do the things. Okay, and it will be, and as we use it more, we will become better in this using of the pronouns. Okay, now let me go to the next type of pronouns, that is demonstrative pronouns. Okay, demonstrative pronouns, let me explain you what is demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns means pronouns that points out something. Okay, this, that, these, those, these words are called demonstrative words. Okay, these are demonstrative because they demonstrate, they show something, they point out something, isn't it? So that is why they are called demonstrative words. Now here we are going to study demonstrative pronouns, and in the process we will be also able to learn demonstrative adjectives also. Okay, how? It is very easy to understand. If the demonstrative words are alone, there is no noun after the demonstrative words in a sentence. If suppose there is a demonstrative word, and after the demonstrative word if there is no noun, then it is demonstrative pronoun, then it is a demonstrative pronoun. But if in a sentence there is a demonstrative word and after the demonstrative word there is a noun, then they become demonstrative adjectives. Okay, student, you need to understand it very clearly, because the future chapter adjective is also, that is what we are learning here also. That is, if the demonstrative word is there and if there is no noun, if there, after the demonstrative word the rest of the sentence is there, and in after the demonstrative word if there is no noun, right after the demonstrative word there is no noun, then it is a demonstrative pronoun. But right after the demonstrative word, if there is a noun, then it is a demonstrative adjective. Okay, let us look into the examples. Example 1. This is very beautiful. The sentence is, this is very beautiful. The demonstrative word is this. After that, is very beautiful. There is no noun. So, it becomes a demonstrative pronoun. Okay, next example. Those are empty glasses. Those are empty glasses. Now, those are empty glasses. After, right after those, there is no noun. So, it is a demonstrative pronoun. Okay, now let us try to understand demonstrative adjective. Example 3. That elephant is very huge. The demonstrative word is that. Right after that, there is a noun, elephant, isn't it? So that becomes demonstrative adjective. Okay, look at example 4. These flowers are very colorful. The demonstrative word is these. Right after the word these, there is a noun, flowers, isn't it? So because of that, the word these becomes demonstrative adjective. Okay, so once again I repeat, if there is no noun right after the demonstrative word, then it is a demonstrative pronoun, and right after the demonstrative word, if there is a noun, then it is a demonstrative adjective. Okay, students, now let us go to the next type of pronoun, that is interrogative pronoun. Students, here also it is very similar to demonstrative pronouns. The interrogative words, there are 11 interrogative words, but for purpose of pronoun and adjective, we only want 5. That is, who, whom, whose, which, and what. Okay. These interrogative words, the same policy like demonstrative pronoun. If after these interrogative words, right after these interrogative words, if there is a noun, then it becomes interrogative adjective. And right after these interrogative words, if there is no noun, it becomes an interrogative pronoun. Okay, I repeat once again, right after the interrogative words, if there is no noun, it is an interrogative pronoun. And right after the interrogative word, if there is a noun, it becomes interrogative adjective. Example 1, what is this? So, after what, there is no noun. So, it is an interrogative pronoun. Next is, who is the speaker? After the interrogative word who, there is no noun, so it is an interrogative pronoun. Let us look at the next one. Which book are you reading? The interrogative word is which. Right after that, there is a noun, book, so it becomes interrogative adjective. And example 4, whose sketch pens are these? Whose is the interrogative word? Right after that, there is a noun, sketch pens, so it becomes interrogative adjective. You understand, students? This is how we can identify interrogative adjectives and interrogative pronouns. So, along with the pronouns, we have studied two types of adjectives, that is demonstrative adjective and interrogative adjective. Okay, students? So, that is all for this part, and the rest of the pronouns I'll be explaining in the part 2. Okay? Thank you, children.